Just a second, and then read for you the Beatitudes. Here we go. It says, verse 23 of chapter 4 of the book of Matthew, Jesus was going all over Galilee, just like us. Teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. Then the news about him spread throughout Syria. So they brought to him all those who were afflicted, those suffering from various diseases and intense pains, the demon-possessed, the epileptics, the paralytics, and he healed them. Large crowds followed him from Galilee, Decapolis, Jerusalem, Judea, and beyond the Jordan. When he saw the crowds, he went up on the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, because the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are those who mourn, because they will be comforted. Blessed are the gentle, because they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, because they will be clothed. Blessed are the merciful, because they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, because they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, because they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness, because the kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and falsely say every kind of evil against you because of you. Be glad and rejoice, because your reward is great in heaven. For that is how they persecuted the prophets who were before you." One last thing I want to read for you. But before I do, remember that Jesus, the Beatitudes, is a hint. It's actually a 180-degree moment for many who are hearing them that day, because they had believed that because we were poor, we were finished, because we had mercy, we had deliverance, because we made peace to other people, we weren't going to receive benefits. And so you had to be hard, and you had to be rich. Those were the signs that God was blessing them. And Jesus said, "No, no, no." And then he said, "You are the salt of the earth. If you turn everything on your head, you will flavor the world." Thank you.
Please.
So then he says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its taste, how can it be made salty? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled by the men. You are the light of the world. A city situated on a hill cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and puts it under a basket, but rather on a lampstand, and it gives light for all who are in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven." This is the word.
Thanks be to God.